bursting at the seams, unpacking an English idiom. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to our channel, where we dive into the fascinating world of English language learning. Today, we're going to explore a very interesting phrase that you might have heard or read somewhere. Bursting at the seams. We'll unpack its meaning, usage, and origins to help you understand how and when to use it in everyday English. So, let's get started. The phrase, bursting at the seams, is an idiom in the English language. An idiom is a phrase where the words together have a meaning that is different from the dictionary definitions of the individual words. When we say something is bursting at the seams, we are usually not talking about clothing or objects that are literally tearing apart because they are too full. Instead, this phrase is often used metaphorically to describe a situation where something is filled to its capacity or beyond, leading to a sense of being overly full or crowded. For example, if a classroom is so full of students that it cannot accommodate any more, you might say the classroom is bursting at the seams. To better understand how to use this phrase, let's look at a few examples. 1. After the holiday sales, the store was bursting at the seams with customers. Here, the phrase describes a store so full of people that it seems like it can't hold any more. 2. The bus was bursting at the seams during rush hour. This example paints a picture of a bus so crowded that it seems to be overflowing. 3. Our schedule is bursting at the seams with meetings and deadlines. In this case, the phrase metaphorically describes a schedule that is so packed it can't possibly fit anything more. The origin of bursting at the seams is quite literal and comes from the imagery of something being so full that its seams, the lines where two pieces of fabric are sewn together, start to burst or break apart because they cannot contain the contents. This idiom has been used in English for many years and is a vivid way to express the concept of overcapacity or being overly full, whether it's referring to physical spaces, objects, or abstract concepts like time. And that wraps up our exploration of the idiom, bursting at the seams. We hope this video has given you a clear understanding of what this phrase means, how to use it, and where it comes from. Idioms like these can add color and expressiveness to your English, making your conversations more vivid and engaging. Keep practicing, and don't hesitate to use bursting at the seams in your own sentences when the situation fits. Thank you for watching, and we hope to see you in our next video.